ask you something. Which one is Jesus? Look at these signs right here.
Which one?
Which one is Jesus? Which one is Jesus? Which one is Jesus? Which one is Jesus?
This one.
Which one?
This one.
You've guessed correct, but the question is, why do our people believe that this is Jesus? Why do people believe that this is Jesus right here? Guess what? Because this was beaten and whipped into our backs to believe that this was Jesus. And I'm going to show you that. Give me Revelation chapter 13, verse 15. Black man, you've been lied to all your life. We are the Jews. We are God's children. Not no one else. We've been lied to. And we're going to be exposed to two biggest lies today. Whether you care or not. Because we clearly don't. We've been sent out here to show our people the truth. Thus saith the Lord. I'm going to show you why our people believe in this demon right here. Read what you got. Revelation chapter 13, verse 15.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 13, verse 15.
Come on.
And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast.
How? He is talking about the so-called Caucasian race. Pope Alexander VI gave birth to this demon right here, which was his homosexual son, which today carried on and believe and make believe that this was Jesus the Christ. How? That's how they gave power to this. Read on.
That the image of the beast should both speak.
What does the Bible call this?
The beast.
The what?
The beast.
This is the image of the beast right here. All I'm speaking is Bible talk. This is the image of the beast. You're worshiping the beast. If you're worshiping this image right here, if you believe that this is Jesus the Christ, read on.
And cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed.
Should be what?
Should be killed.
Brother, were we not whipped and beaten and slaughtered? And guess what the people who brought this image did? They did that exact thing. Whipped us into subjection, believing this is your master. The same man that came and beat you and packed you on those slave ships, he came with his image. He came with his God, and he made your black tail believe that, guess what, that's God too. That's God too. The same people who beat, whipped, destroyed us, made you believe that the white man is God. But guess what? He is no God.
Right.
He's the demon. He's the devil. He's the beast the Bible talks about. Read on. Read again.
And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast.
How did he also give power to this image right here? You ever seen movies like Passion of the Christ? You ever seen movies, TV shows depicting this? That's how they're giving life to this image. And that's why you believe that this is Jesus. But guess what? This is a lie. This is a billion-dollar lie to keep you asleep, keep you mentally destroyed. Because the white man put his God off on you, and his God looks just like him. Imagery means everything. Hold that. Give me Proverbs chapter 29, verse 18. I'm not speaking what I feel. We speak in Bible. That's what we're speaking, all right? Proverbs chapter 29 and verse 18. You see it, brother? You see this, brother?
Yeah, I got
you. See this, brother? This is history. This is history that we're speaking. Hold on. I'm going to give you some more, brother. Proverbs chapter 29, verse 18. Read what you got.
This is the book of Proverbs chapter 29 and verse 18.
Because imagery is powerful. You see these images right here at the top of the screen, at the top of the sign right here?
Right. Yeah.
They would like to say, and look, and scholars understand these things. They'll show you and say, hey, on these old temples or churches that's over on the side in Europe, they have black images standing. In Jerusalem, they have black images of our forefathers and foremothers up. And guess what they tell you? Your black tail can't go back there and look at those things. Why? Because they understand that's power in imagery. They'll sit here and say, you see these dark images? They'll say that, look, it was a fire that happened around the church or something like that, and that's why it got burned. Okay, but why is the image right here, his cloth? What color is that cloth right there? Why is that cloth right there? What color is that cloth right there?
Is it
the same color as this right here? Okay, so if it was a fire or it got burned, why isn't the clothes burned either? Why is that dark right here, but this isn't dark right here? It's called the Jedi mind trick. That's what it's called, the Jedi mind trick. No, the forefathers of the Bible, they were black people. They were black people, and we're going to prove it, thus saith the Lord. I'm going to show you how powerful imagery is. Get this, Proverbs 29, verse 18.
Proverbs chapter 29 and verse 18.
Get mad at this.
Where there is no vision.
Where what?
where there is no vision.
Listen up, brother. Don't be afraid of this. This truth coming out. It is what it is. It might hurt, but guess what? It's the truth. Read what you got.
The people perish.
Without an image, the people perish. Our people perish every day. Why? Because behind this image right here. Our people die every day. Why? Spiritually. Spiritually. I'm going to show you why. Hold that. Give me Proverbs chapter 21, verse 16. Our people die behind this image every single day and what it means. And what it means. That I'm going to show you. Proverbs chapter 21 and verse 16. How do we die every day? Read what you got.
The book of Proverbs chapter 21 and verse 16.
Come on.
The man that wandereth out of the way of understanding.
The understanding of this Bible is this Bible. That calls down to what God wants for his people and what the people of the book look like. Read on.
Shall remain in the congregation of the dead.
Of the what?
Of the dead.
Of the what?
Of the dead.
Of the living.
Of the dead.
So our people die that are caught up in the doctrine of Christianity. Why? Because this is what comes with it. This is what comes with it. This is what comes with it. So every night when you close your eyes and you're praying to God, 9 times out of 10, you're going off of what the public makes you believe in what God looks like. But guess what? Newsflash, the God and creator of this earth, guess what? He's a black man.
That's right.
He's a black man. Right. You want me to prove it? Let's prove it. Go hold that. Give me Daniel chapter 7, verse 9. We're going to show you. I'm not going to give you my words. I'm going to give you the words of this Bible. Right. Because our image has been hidden for too long. The truth has been hidden for too long. No more. Not anymore. 2021, you will know the truth. Read what you got. Let's read what color the Father is. Read what you got.
This is the book of Daniel, chapter 7, and verse 9.
Listen up, black man. This is about you right here.
Let me read. I beheld till the thrones were cast down.
So this is a vision of the end. All the kingdoms of the earth were cast out. Even, guess what? America. America, the greatest kingdom on the face of this earth. Cast down. Read on.
And the Ancient of Days did sit.
Who sat?
The Ancient of Days did sit.
The Father, who's older than time, sat. Guess what? To sit down, you gotta have a body. You have to have a body. The Father has a physical body.
Right.
Let's see what that physical body has on it. Read.
Whose garment was white as snow.
Come on.
And the hair of his head.
The what?
The hair of his head.
I thought the Father and everything in heaven were spirits. Why does he have a head? Why does he have hair? What are we reading? We're reading the Bible, which you blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans refuse to pay attention to.
Right.
And everything that you need for your life has always been hidden in a book. But guess what? You ain't gonna read no book. You ain't gonna read no book. Only thing you're gonna do is sit here, get on YouTube, or you're gonna watch TV. And you're gonna continue to be lied to you by the beast. Keep reading.
And the hair of his head, like the pure wool.
Like the what?
The pure wool.
Like the what?
The pure wool.
Guess what, Hispanic man? Guess what, black man? At one point in time, you Hispanic man, you had woolly hair.
Right.
Guess what, black man? You have woolly hair.
Right.
The Father, the God of all of creation, has woolly hair. Guess what? He's a black man. He's a black man. Get mad. Hold that. Give me John chapter 14. What does his son look like? What does his son look like? What does God, the creator of everything, what does his son look like? John chapter 14. What is it? Verse 8? John chapter 14, verse 8. Bring it out.
The book of John, chapter 14 and verse 8.
Listen up, black man, black woman. You have been lied to. You have been lied to all your life. Your life has purpose. You were created more than just to pay bills and die.
Right.
That you are on this earth. God, you are God on this earth. That's what you are, black man. But guess what? You choose to live as a nigga. You choose to live and die as a black man in America. There's more than life than that, black man. And I see what the greatest man of all time look like. Read what you got.
Philip saith unto him,
come on,
Lord, show us the Father.
So Philip, the disciple of Christ, who's obviously with him every single day, sees he's looking at Jesus the Christ in the flesh, not the spirit, in the flesh. Read on.
And it sufficeth us. Jesus saith unto him,
come on,
Have I not been so long time with you?
Christ said himself, I've always been with you, Philip. You see me, right? I'm standing right in front of you, Philip, right? You see what I look like? Let's see what God looks like. Read.
And yet hast thou not known me, Philip?
Come on.
He that has seen me has seen the Father.
What does Christ look like? Let's go to Revelation. Let's not play with them. Let's go to Daniel 10 first. Because guess what? Christ has always been in the Bible. He's been in the old and he's in the new. Guess what? Our forefathers prophesied about Christ since the beginning of time.
Right.
Since the beginning of time. So guess what? You need the Old Testament. You need the Old Testament. You need the whole book.
Right.
So let's see, what does the greatest man of all time look like? Sister over there talking to my brothers, what does Christ look like? Let's start it off. Let's be real. Let's stop lying to each other. What's Christ look like? I'll give anybody right now all the money out of my bank account to prove that he's a white man. Come step forth right here to prove that Christ is a white man. You can have the chorus out of my pocket. You can have them right now. Anybody, step forth and prove to me that Jesus was a white man. Let's see what Jesus the Christ looks like. Give me Daniel 10 and verse 5.
The book of Daniel, chapter 10 and verse 5.
Come on.
Then I lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, a certain man clothed in linen.
So Daniel is seeing a vision of Christ. Let's see what Christ looks like. The guy, the same guy that you go to church every single day and say that you believe in. Let's see what he looks like. Read.
Whose loins were girded with fine gold of Euphaz.
Hold on, I thought Christ was a spirit. If he has a garment on, he has a body. Let's use common sense, people. Read.
His body also was like the barrel.
Hold on, his what?
His body was also like the barrel.
His what?
His body also was like the barrel.
Read.
And his face had the appearance of lightning.
So Christ had a fierce countenance on his face. He wasn't no quiet church boy. Because that's what Christianity has made the black man. Soft,
right.
Weak, docile. That's what Christianity has made the black man today. Weak. Your women rule over you, black man. Your children oppress you, black man. That's what happened. That's what happens when we fail to the white man. That's what happened. Read on.
His body was also like the barrel.
Come on.
And his face had the appearance of lightning.
Come on.
And his eyes as lamps of fire.
Come on.
And his arms and his feet like in color to polished brass.
Hold up. Stop the system. Shut everything down. It said his body like in color to what?
Like in color to polished brass.
Y'all might not want to hear the truth of this, but guess what? Christ was, he was here today. He'll be a black man, blackity black. A Negro, a nigga. That's what he would be like if he was on this earth today. But y'all don't want to believe that. Why? Because you're so deep rooted in the system of lies. You love your oppression. You love lies. That's the problem. And that's why you're going to remain asleep.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.